I switched the overlay. Yeah. Spawning at the top right for Team Stratic Gaming. In purple, it's our Terran player, Intai. Sweet logo, bros. Sweet logo. And his opponent, quite possibly the worst Zerg player on Earth. It's our teal Zerg player for Outset Gaming. It is Roxas. I have no idea what Lanaya is. Is that some, like, League of Legends thing? Because, yeah, I don't know. Given the icon that he has there, I feel like that's something like, I don't know. Probably something super nerdy. Someone knows, just tell me. I doubt Roxas is here, but... Oh, Roxas. He's a good buddy of mine. I actually started watching Roxas stream this game, actually, on his personal stream. And I was watching at the beginning of it and ridiculing him. Told him not to screw up, so we'll see how he did. I'm not too sure. I left the game. I left the stream, so I wouldn't know what actually happened. So I can cast this. And Roxas is going to scout. He loves drone scouting. He talks about drone scouting so much. This is a really, really early drone scout, though. I'm not really sure how necessary it is to drone scout on, what was that, 13, 12, basically. What are you going to see? Actually, he's going to see CC first. So that could help him a lot, actually. So that doesn't work out pretty nicely for him. He's already going to be going hatch first, probably. And he's going to see a CC first, so he's going to be nice and safe to go gasless. And even if he's super ballsy, going for like a third hatch or something. And he's going to be annoying. He's going to keep this drone around this base and just keep his opponent from doing exactly what he wants. But SAV is going to be able to get around and maybe start building the CC before the drone is going to be able to deny it. Possibly actually he'll try to put the CC on the low ground. So he's feeling super ballsy. I think he saw that it was a hatch first, so he feels okay putting this hatch on the low ground. And yeah, Roxas is going to come over here and start harassing this worker, I imagine. And already, there's already an SCV down here for Intai, so he's going to be just fine. Yes, CM, this is the Roxas that cast SCV Rush. That's why I'm making fun of him. And actually, at the same time, Roxas is going to kill off this SCV. Use a lot of drones to do it, but both players being annoying with their early drones. Early scouts. And Intai is setting up here nicely. Still no gas yet, so this could still be a lot of things. One of my favorite builds to do is going gasless, expand, and then adding on two gases and going into Hellbat drops. It's never expected. Never expected as a new Zerg player. But Roxas already thrown in a third hatchery, and that was before his pool came down, so it's going to be a three hatch versus a CC first. There's still a lot of damage Intai can do early, even though he did go CC first, especially against this three hatch play, depending on what he decides to do with his gas. So this could turn out a lot of fun, or turn into a very, very long game. We'll wait and see. Natural bases are done for both players here, already turning into an orbital command, and Intai's probably going to be adding on a bunker here. Just one second here. And Marine's coming up. So probably be a quicker factory. As soon as 100 gas is collected, he'll be going into a factory. For some Hellions, and then I would imagine into bio. Still no second gas yet, so there's no reason this would necessarily point to mech at this point. Mech has kind of grown in favor amongst Terran in TVZ recently, but Mutalisk are pretty freaking good, and it's really hard to engage Swarmhost versus Muta sometimes, or Swarmhost and Muta against with mech. But there's a lot of options still for Intai. He is throwing in this factory, and I imagine it's going to be a reactor as soon as he has 50 gas here, which is right now-ish. There it goes. Yep. So we'll be seeing some Hellions coming out, and just three queens on the way all at the same time here for Roxas. So he's going to get right into these injects, still gasless, and just completely just droning up right now. So both players are heavily focusing on their economy. No third command center just yet from Intai. He does have a second gas now, so... that is a rather kind of an earlier second gas, so this still could be a sort of a mech play from him, depending on what he decides to do with the second gas, or it could just be something for like Banshees quicker, a little bit quicker, and actually it's going to be a second factory, so with this second factory coming in, this could be like a two factory Blue Flame Hellion push, and against only Lings, which is all that Roxas is really going to have, and they're not going to have a speed for a pretty long time, and if you don't recognize that this Blue Flame is going to be happening, basically before it even hits you, it is extremely annoying to fend off. But Roxas is actually scouting out basically as perfectly as possible. He's seeing another factory here. He doesn't know this is the second factory, but he can probably assume this is the second factory. And seeing that this tech lab is here, this is pretty much for sure going to be Blue Flame. Marine gonna be starting to push away this Overlord. Overlord doesn't really need to die at the moment. There's no reason, real reason for it to die. He does see that there is two gases. He knows there's two gases. And actually, adding, Entai's adding on a tech lab on this Vector as well, so looks like he still wants to play bio. Just getting two quick factories here and a third command center at the same time. And behind this, Roxas is kind of setting up, getting a Roachborn as well as two Evo Chambers at his front, so he can be as walled off as possible against a lot of Hellions, which eventually is going to be the case here. But right now, there's nothing really coming from this. Okay, Blue Flame is on the way, and Entai is pretty supply blocked at the moment. It's always really annoying to set everything up the way you need to as a Terran player and not get supply blocked, which is kind of the problem for Entai at the moment. So despite this really quick Blue Flame and a bunch of Hellions push that we're going to see, Entai is looking to go bio here. It's also, instead of having mines, a lot of Terrans will go into Hellbats as their kind of tanky unit against a lot of Banelings. And if Roxas misreads this and goes straight in, and he is going straight into his ranged upgrades for Roaches and Hydras. So it looks like he thinks he's playing mech. But that's not really the case. He does see an engineering bay right now with this Overlord. So he kind of has a hint that this is probably going to be not mech, but that engineering bay could just be for turrets, so we don't know. Drones trying to get out of here, but they're just going to get roasted up. There's no point in doing that. Two Spry Colors at the third base. There's one Spry Color as well in the main. He's just trying to get those. He's trying to evacuate those drones, but that kind of really just backfired. Leaving the drones here at least would have forced Entai to fight into them to actually kill them. One Hellion is at 2 health, so it's going to die pretty quickly. A couple Queens are here, and Roach is already out, so these Hellions are going to have to push away a little bit. Blue Flame is finished, but yeah, Entai doesn't... He's okay. He killed off a few workers there. He got 8 workers from that, which is alright. That's a nice opening. Whatever. That works. And he still has these Hellions out, so he's got map control for a while. Even scanning to see what's happening exactly, and there's not really much happening. Lair is just now about 33% done. And another hatchery is done for Roxas. And Entai did what he wanted to do. He's got 3 command centers, and he's kept his opponent kind of low on workers. And he's going to start taking his third base as soon as he possibly can. +1/+1 on the way for his bio. Stim on, or Comet Shield on the way, Stim on the way as well. And he's going to start going into tanks and some more Hellions. And eventually he's going to be able to turn those Hellions into Hellbats. Fare a little bit better against these Roaches. And actually, Roaches are going to be moving across the map, seeing what they can get done. They're kind of empty supply at the moment. He made them. He doesn't really want to have to have had made them. So he wants to check things out. He knows the third base isn't done yet. And actually, he's doing it nicely here. He's going to spread creep with this area. There's not a whole lot to choose off. There are good enough Marines, I guess. So that Overlord will die. But the creep's going to be there for a little while. Can be kind of annoying, and Creep is at this base as well, so Rox is doing basically everything he can to keep his opponent stuck on two bases as long as possible, and he's actually switching over to melee upgrades now. He did get 1-1 for his ranged, but that's kind of unnecessary, and seeing that his opponent is actually going into bio, he doesn't really want to have to deal with having only Roaches and Hydras against a bunch of bio, which really doesn't work too well, especially when there are tanks involved, and there is a tank out here, so... Entai doesn't know about this Overlord here. He's actually moving his command center right now. He's going to push over there as soon as he sees that and take out that Overlord eventually. Burrow doesn't have to be finished. No, Burrow isn't finished, so the Ling isn't going to be able to burrow and be even more annoying, make a waste of scan on that. Hellion's going to be moving around the map, taking what control they can. 1-1 about to finish up here for Entai. He's going to go directly into 2-2, and that's a lot of Hellions. That is a lot of Hellions. Gonna take out this queen here, just fine. And actually, it looks like Roxas has kind of given up on securing this base as his third, and has decided to take this base as his third instead. There's more drones over there, because he feels a little bit safer. Roaches are gonna try to push in here and take out the rest of these Hellions. Spine Colors are doing some work, and Roaches coming in from behind are gonna kill off a lot of these Hellions. A couple of them escape. Not a terrible trade there for Entai. He kills 3 more workers, got a queen as well. But now there's a pretty large army out for Roxas. The army supply is pretty even, and there is a nice amount of upgrades for our Terran player, but he doesn't have any medevacs yet. The first medevac is just now being created, so this is going to take a little while for Entai to deal with, and actually a large engage coming in here, and before medevacs are out, this is going to be very, very annoying for our Terran player, but Stim is finished. He's going to be able to push this away pretty easily. It's a good amount of Marauders, actually. He's going to push that back without any real problems. 2-2 is already on the way from as well. Plus 2 Carapace is just about to finish up 4 Roxas. So there's really no need for him to attack, and he realizes that. He doesn't want to lose units for no reason. He's not going to get a nice trade out of that, no matter what he does. He's going to back off and get into higher tech if he can. First Mutalisks are on the way as well. Burrow is just about to finish. And there's only one turret. Actually, there's 2 turrets. Excuse me. There's 2 turrets in the main. Only one at the natural. One being built at the third. So these Mutalisks are going to be annoying. There's not too many of them, though. They don't have any upgrades. There's actually 9 more on the way to join the 7 that are already out. So we're going to have 16 Mutalisks. And 16 Mutalisks does a good amount of damage very quickly. This is going to be extremely annoying for Entei to deal with for a while. His medevac count is still pretty low, only 3 out in the field right now. But he already has a Thor on the way. So, actually, Roxas running into a turret here. 1 meter goes down. He's not going to lose a second one, but once he pokes in here, he's going to see more turrets. He's going to run away. But at the same time, he's been moving his ground army around and he's got a nice amount of map vision right now. I mean, look where he is on the map compared to his Terran opponent, who doesn't really see much of anything. He sees what's going on at his main base, but that's about it. You know, Roxas is out in the middle of the map doing a lot of work figuring this out, but there's no Banelings. Absolutely no Banelings. There's a ton of bio with Hellbat support, regardless of the Banelings not being there. So, yeah, Entei is in a pretty good spot for a while. Mutas swinging in, doing what damage they can, taking out another turret. The remaining turrets get surrounded by the SCVs, giving it a nice little hug there, and he's also going to start throwing down a lot more turrets and being a jerk like that and keeping himself safe. Who does that, right? 2-2 finish for a Terran player here, and there isn't really a great army for Roxas. It's going to be really difficult for him to actually engage into this bio force here. Mutalisks going to try to swing in and kill off the tank, but just completely unable to do so. And Entei is in a really nice position here. Actually, the Mutas flying over all the bio army. One tank still left over. And Bio is pushing into this third base here, and he's going to have to evacuate this as soon as possible. Actually, a few Banelings, but they do not have speed. And Entei's just going to run back against this, and with the tank here, Mutas not engaging this. Huge, huge choke point here. The entire army basically dies for Roxas there. 93 army supply to 54 now. Only these Mutas left over, basically. A lot of Bio here. Going to kill off this third base pretty easily. And he's going to put this at a three base versus three base Zerg versus Terran, which is never where you want to be as a Zerg player. And there's really not much on the field right now for Roxas. He's got a bunch of Lings sitting in his main base. I'm trying to make as many Banelings as he possibly can. He doesn't have much gas. Actually, he's got a ton of gas. What the hell? Make gas. Make units. Roxas has a lot of money, just no larva, I guess. Yeah, he's only got 8 larva right now. These bases were so long to get up, and we're getting those queens sniped off by the Hellions. Made this very, very difficult. And Mita's actually getting killed off basically for free. Even the Thor getting a lot of damage here. 5 kills in that Thor. Army is pretty low on health at the moment, but that's not a big deal. And Entei is feeling pretty okay about just taking things out. Only +1/+2 for the melee units. A lot more Banelings being morphed in. And I feel like Roxas is going to try to wait for these Evil Chambers to die off. But no, he's going to go for this instead. There is a ton of Marauders. And a whole lot of Marauders versus a lot of Banelings isn't the worst of trade situations. Actually, I think a lot of those Banes are about to explode on the Thor. Yeah. Banelings kill off a Thor, which is never what would have happened, and that's a ton of bio left over. 161 to 83 supply here, and it looks like Entei is setting himself up to take game number 3 for Stratic Gaming here. Massive supply advantage for him here. Adding in a fourth base back home, adding a couple more barracks, just continuing to rally across the map. These are a lot of low-health Marauders, but still Marauders nonetheless, actually burrowing some of these things. Roxas has a good amount of money left over, but he's just not able to actually run into this force. And it's basically all Marauders, and Banelings don't do so well against Marauders, and another force is back here that's not even engaging with this main one. This force could come down and take out this base if it's so pleased. Roxas just kind of looking at his current situation and feeling kind of upset. Not much you can do. There aren't many Marines, so Mutas could do a lot of damage. Actually, Mutas is going to force this back for a little bit. They killed off all the Marines. Where are the Marines? There's not many Marines. There's only 20 Marines. It's not a lot. I think a lot of Marines actually back home, too. So Roxas pushes his back, and he's calling up as much bio as he can, but he's lost his natural base. He's lost his third/fourth base here. He's lost 41 workers so far in this game. 63 workers to 41 right now. A fourth base is going to be made here for our Terran player. Mutas is going to try to swing in and do some damage, but there are already a good amount of turrets in the base. Mutas are going to start dying. 2 turrets is not really a trade you want to take, and 137 to 34 army supply right now in favor of the Terran player. Yeah. going to be a little bit difficult for a little while. And Army's going to start pushing over and say, hey, what's up, Mutas? Go away. This is my base. This is my base right here. Roxas saving his Banely Nest with an Overlord spreading creep. Poor Banely Nest. We have a max Terran player. No 3-3 yet. 3-3 isn't on the way for the bio. I'd like to see that. And Roxas is trying to do what he can. But there's a good amount of turrets everywhere that he goes. Mutas do have plus one, but against a good amount of turrets, it doesn't really matter. He's just not the effective trades that he really wants to have. 200 supply to 75 at the moment. I don't think Entei realizes how far ahead he actually is. Roxas is taking as many bases as possible right now, knowing that he's behind, he just needs to get the larva production that he wants. He's got a queen that's not really doing anything. Inject queen, inject. Doesn't have a queen down here. Where are the queens at? Oh, who cares? 199 to 200 supply. And just more and more units are dying. A nice kind of link counterattack here. Taking out a good amount of units. Okay, Roxas is keeping himself in this. Gotta say, gotta hand to him. He's kept it in this for a while. But this is still not looking too great for him. 200 supply to 94. Scan goes down. What's it saying? It's not saying anything. I don't know where that scan went. Oh, scan was in the main. That's where it was. Again, Mutas trying to do what they can. Swinging around, being as annoying as possible, but again, turrets everywhere. Turrets everywhere. 3-3 is finally on the way. About 30% done there. Mutas running into more and more turrets, and this is a big friggin' army. That is a large army. Look at that. Look at that army. Look at that sweet Terran army. And Mutas flying into more turrets, losing more and more here. He's lost 31 Mutas so far in this game. Yeah, that's a bit much. Actually, he's going in a swarm house, but look at the units lost amount right now, 20,000 to 9,000 in favor of the Zerg player. That's kind of rough. Banelings rolled in, did a good amount of damage here. Actually, he burrowed those, but there's a lot of turrets around here. Not really much of use there. So that happened. Again, Roxas is running around, countering, doing as much as he can. He's killing off a lot of workers with these little counters, and Entei is letting him kind of claw his way back into this game, and with a lot of swarm hosts, this could be super annoying. Just to engage and actually take out. And Roxas is actually going to Hive as well. Getting another Evo Chamber finally again. The Locusts do have plus one for their attack, actually, so they're not completely naked. But, yeah. That's still a very big army. I'm pretty sure Entei could move, not even a move, just move on top of these Swarm Hosts and start attacking, and he'd be just fine. Really not much that he can do here. My dog is randomly barking in my bedroom. Not sure why. He's insane. Entei, just moving in, being as safe as possible. Forte, that's enough. Relax. Silly dog is silly. Yeah, that's a huge buy, of course. They have 3-3. They got a lot of medivacs. We've got 10 medivacs on the field against. 10 swarm hosts versus 10 medivacs. I'm pretty sure that healing power is going to be just fine against this. Another base goes down for Roxas here. He's now on three bases. Main is completely mined out. His natural is almost mined out. And yeah, this is all the army that Roxas has left now. 195 spot to 103, so to give Roxas credit, he was a lot further behind earlier on in this game. And he kept himself in this for a long time. And still, this Bioforce is having some issues actually cleaning this up. Another big run by over at the third base, but it's not going to be enough. And Roxas calls the GG there. So, good game there. Stratic is going to go up.